And a pleasant good evening and welcome to North Idaho College for tonight's Scenic West Athletic Conference action between the NIC Cardinals and the Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. Good evening. This is Dick Haugen as we welcome you inside our broadcast booth. The Cardinals coming in at 3-3 in conference play. Colorado Northwestern, well, they've had a tough year at 0-7. The Cardinals, rare losers of two in a row, a very tough loss this past Saturday to CSI, losing 72-70 at the buzzer. Had a chance to talk with head coach Chris Carlson moments ago about that loss and tonight's matchup. We'll hear from the coach right after this timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
With Cardinal coach Chris Carlson as the Cards return home to face Colorado Northwestern tonight and Utah State Eastern on Saturday. But first, coach, let's go back. A heartbreaking loss at CSI, a buzzer beater, if you will, and doggone it, first time you play CSI, goes to double overtime. Second time, you lose with a half a second left. Just can't get over the hump.
Yeah. I don't want to go back to that game, Dick, so let's just move forward, okay?
All right. Well,
we'll go back to CSI and try to get a better outcome next time. But, no, that, we did some things really well that we wanted to do, but there was just a few things that, you know, had us playing catch-up again. And, you know, it's a tough loss. I do like a lot of things that are happening. So I think we really focused on what we need to do here at this stretch coming off that game. There's a lot of disappointment. So, We just want to play a 40-minute game and be a little more solid.
All right, and of course, there were good things, the ability to come back against a CSI team that's always tough at home and have it come to the last shot. It's just one of those things, and let's hope your team can build from it. 15-4, 3-3 in the Scenic West Athletic Conference, an opportunity to get well home tonight against Colorado Northwestern.
Yeah, it's nice to be back home, and it's been a while, so... We got two losses in a row now. We haven't had that happen yet, so it's time to turn this thing around and get back on a winning track tonight.
The situation where we've been on the road, we have the one home game with CSI, and then on the road again and back and forth. So it's a situation. It's the Scenic West Athletic Conference, and talking with Randy Rogers down at CSI, he's never seemed so topsy turvy. You never know what can happen on any given night. Anybody can beat anybody.
Yeah. Oh, I think so. You know, Salt Lake and snow are going this weekend, and we just got two home games, and we need to take care of business here on our home court and get back on the winning column and start getting on a roll, because there are some tough road trips ahead.
All right, let's talk about some of the things you want to do to get back on that winning bandwagon, if you will, tonight against Colorado Northwestern. A couple of things that you'll be focusing on.
Yeah, I think defensively we got to come out better. We gave up a lot of points in that first quarter. And the game before that we lost, gave up a lot of points in that third quarter. So, you know, we got to come out in the first and third quarters after halftime and play some defense the way we're capable of. And that'll be a focus tonight.
One thing about our defense, it tends to lead to easy offensive points when you get Stormy and Grace inside getting rebounds and you get, you know, Monica and Macy out on the wings on a break.
Yeah. Hey, second shots are great. And Stormy and Shelby and Grace Vark, I mean, those guys have been on the boards pretty hard. Ebony and Jocelyn been on the boards. So, that when you get second shots, boy, that doubles your opportunity to score. So we got to keep on doing that one there, and it's nice to have kids roaming around on the perimeter. We've got some nice guards out there right now.
All right, and everybody is playing well. Gracie Roberts and Alyssa Case coming off your bench, and you mentioned Jocelyn Cook-Cox. She's having an outstanding year as well.
Yeah, all three of those guys. There's not even a doubt they're going to play every game, and gives us depth, and they all have had some really strong games this year. So Gracie Roberts, I think, slowly is doing some nice things out there. I think she's more of a shooting guard, scoring wing type player, but she wanted to give this point guard a run, and she's starting to get a little bit of it figured out. So Jocelyn's been the most steady of the three, I think, all year, and her athleticism and quickness has been real nice. So it's nice to have depth.
All right. Nothing better than home cooking, too, huh, Coach?
Yeah. Oh, this is great. I'm stoked. I'm ready to go.
All right. The Cardinals against the Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. That, of course, coming up Saturday at home against Utah State Eastern. The Golden Eagles, we'd love to see you both tonight and Saturday here at Roley Williams Court. Coach, appreciate your time.
Thanks, Dick.
All right. Chris Carlson starting lineups and the tip-off right after the break.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Hi, Jim Sunny and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
That's the national anthem, of course, provided tonight by the NIC Pep Band under the direction of Mr. Terry Jones. Let's go back to the PA announcer, Gary Day, with tonight's starting lineups.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing our starters. We begin first with the Spartans from Colorado Northwestern under head coach Brian Wertheimer. A freshman guard, number 10, Rachel Prescott. Sophomore guard, number 12, Tyler Rodriguez. A freshman center, number 21, Shelby Harvey. Freshman center, number 22, Taylor Martin. And freshman guard, number 30, Kylie Tui-O'Neill. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starters for your NIC Cardinals.
from Rhode Island High School in Rhode Island, Oregon, and our sophomore guard at 5'7", number 12, Mason Benedict. From Cannier High School, Cannier, Idaho, our sophomore forward, 6'4", Eagles, number 21, Shelby Roninger. From Brewster High School, Maple Valley, Washington, our sophomore guard at 5'8", number 24, Monica Lander. From Reading High School, Meridian, Idaho, guard at 5'10", freshman number 32, Ebony Norman. And from Sunnyside Christian High School at Sunnyside, Washington, our sophomore forward at 6'8", number 35, Stormy Van Bell.
So there's your starting lineups for both teams. The Cardinals, of course, with a rare two-game losing streak. They're the 25th-ranked team in the latest NJCAA polls. Cardinals at 3-3 in the conference, 15-4 overall. And we'll see how the Cardinals rebound from last Saturday night's heartbreaking 72-70 loss to CSI. Colorado Northwestern, well, all head coach Brian Ortmeier wants is a win. They are 0-7 in conference, 8-11. Overall, so we'll see if the Cardinals can take advantage of some home cooking. Pair 21's jumping at the center. Shelby Clowninger for the Cardinals up against Shelby Harvey for the Spartans in their road blacks. Cardinals in their home whites. First of our doubleheader action tonight. Ball is controlled by the Cardinals. Colorado Northwestern opening in a person defense. Inside, Van Bell shot off the glass, up and in. Nice pass that time by Macy Benedict, and the Cardinals are on the board first. And now full court pressure. Driving down the lane, scoop shot doesn't go that time by Tuamane. And the Cardinals come out of there with it. See if they'll go inside. Once again, they do. Stormy Van Bell back-to-back lay-ins. So obviously, that's the game plan for the Cardinals early. Early and often, go inside. And you heard Chris Carlson in our pregame interview. They're stressing defense. He says, we got to get back to playing defense. Cardinals are in a zone, 2-3 zone. Five on the shot clock. Spartans got to hurry. And they won't even get a shot off. And right away, Colorado Northwestern wants to take a full timeout, and they will. 8:39 remaining in the first period. We'll be right back after the timeout.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Welcome back to North Idaho College. The Cardinals are in sole possession of fourth place in the Scenic West Athletic Conference. Salt Lake on top with a 6-1 record. CSI one game behind at 5-1. Snow College at 5-2. The Cardinals 3-3. Utah State Eastern, which will be here on Saturday, they're 1-6. And Colorado Northwestern 0-7. So the Cardinals looking to get back above the 500 mark with this homestand. Next week, Cardinals are on the road. Thursday in Salt Lake. Saturday will be in Price, Utah to take on Utah State Eastern. So home
home games, boy, you have to take advantage of it. Benedict brings it in the front court. Macy has it tipped from behind, and Prescott ends up with it. Harvey with a shot is up and good. Nice 12-footer by Kelsey Harvey, or Shelby Harvey, my bad. There's a Kelsey and a Shelby, so we'll definitely have to keep an eye on those names to make sure I get the first name in there as well. Foul inside on the Spartans, and they catch Tyra Rodriguez with a grab, her first personal. First team, it'll be out of bounds to the Cardinals on the baseline. Want to welcome all the folks that are watching in the Rangeley, Colorado area. Ebony Norman had it, lost it out of bounds. We'll be back in your neck of the woods here in about 3 weeks. Once again, Cardinals with full court pressure. Prescott. 7:40 remaining first period. Try to get it inside for Martin. And just a little too wide. Out of bounds to the Cardinals on the turnover. Grace Marco checking in for Shelby Cloninger. And last couple ball games, the Lady Cardinals just getting healthy after having a little bit of an illness bug. Van Bell, Norman. Ten on the shot clock. Inside Van Bell. Little runner in the lane. It will count. She got him in the head. And Van Bell with the bucket and the foul. The foul on Prescott, her first, second team foul. Yeah, I had the wrong score up there. Correct that. Counting down to 7 minutes remaining in this first period. Cardinals by four. Knocked out of bounds by Norman. 6:58 on the game clock, 17 on the shot clock. Eight on the shot clock. Spartans going to have to hurry. Five. Rodriguez. Long three ball at the buzzer, but Tuamane does not go, and here comes Monica Landeck. Van Bell in the lane. Doesn't go. Ball tipped away, and I think they're going to get Norman with the personal. It is Norman, that's her first. And speaking of the Cardinals having the sickies, I'm not feeling bad. I just have about a yard of gravel in my throat. Driving in the lane, Prescott off the glass, doesn't go. Offensive rebound, Prescott will pull it out. Tumane in the lane, doesn't go. Offensive board over the head shot by Harvey. What a shot by Harvey. And she puts it in. 6:05 remaining first period. Norman loses it. Rodriguez working on Barco off the glass. Doesn't go. And a travel called on Taylor Martin, who was trying to get control of the basketball away from Stormy Van Bell and took some steps. Benedict launches 15-footer, Macy Benedict with a nice shot. Macy Benedict, ninth in the conference in field goal shooting at 46%. point guard in Chris Carlson's offense, more of a facilitator. Prescott, 8 on the shot clock. 3 on the shot clock. Desperation shot from the corner by Harvey is no good. And the Cardinals come out of there with it. Under 5 minutes remaining. Varco. Benedict launches a long three off to the left. And Chris Carlson wants a timeout. And they're going to call it a 30-second timeout. We'll take a short break as well. We'll be right back after this word from North Idaho College. I'll tell you, Coach Chris Carlson, who's been suffering from back spasms, and said in our pregame show that he'd probably just be standing on the sidelines, not saying much. Boy, he really unloaded on Macy Benedict. I'm not quite sure what he didn't like, but mass substitutions in the ballgame. Shelby Cloninger is back. Alyssa Case is in the ballgame for the first time. Gracie Roberts in for the first time. Jocelyn Cook-Cox in for the first time. So, 3 of the 5 ladies on the court are no longer there. Cloninger inside, Varco off the glass and in. Nice pass and a good finish. 4:24 remaining. Want to mention Alyssa Case will be our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals. I should remind you, all of our Meet the Cardinal guests, if you miss them during the broadcast, they will be on our YouTube page, NICathletics.com, and click on the YouTube banner. Under 4 minutes. Cloninger, step around move, nice move. Missed the lay-in. And Case runs down the long rebound. Cardinals get a new shot clock. Roberts, Cook-Cox, short on the baseline jumper, may have been tipped. Rodriguez, 3 ball, Martin bounces and goes in. Martin gets the shooter's bounce. And at 3:23 remaining in the first period, it's a 3-point Cardinal lead. Cloninger launches a three. Doesn't get it, follows her own rebound. Ball tapped and knocked out of bounds by Cook-Cox. Out of bounds to the Spartans. In for the first time, Sarah Midgley. In for the Spartans, replacing Rodriguez. Also in for the first time, Taylor Thomas. In for the Spartans. And she replaces Kylie Tuimone. Stormy Van Bell back in for NIC. Going to the baseline, and it counts. Oh, they don't count it. Offensive foul as Midgley runs in to Stormy Van Bell. I thought for a minute it was going to be an and one, but I misread the officials' emphatic pointing the other way. I thought he was motioning and one, where I should have said it was offense. Van Bell. Nice pass inside. Cloninger lays it in. Boy, you talk about threading the needle that time. Wow. And Gracie got caught with a leg in the wrong spot. 2:27 remaining, first period. Going to go all the way in the lane. Missed the lane as Midgley And a foul is called. Jocelyn Cook Cox going for the charge. Didn't get it. Her first personal. Second team foul. So Midgley will go to the free throw line. 74% free throw shooter. Cook Cox between the wickets of Stormy Van Bell, couldn't control it. Go the other way. Prescott. And out of bounds to the Spartans. Taylor Martin back in for the Spartans, replacing Shelby Harvey. 21 on the shot clock, 2:01 on the game clock. That is in the corner. Two minutes. Driving the baseline off the glass and in. Midgley with a bucket. Cardinals by two. Cardinals really trying to get the ball inside to Stormy Van Bell. Cloninger with a three. Doesn't go. Thomas with a Spartan rebound. Colorado Northwestern can tie it with a bucket. Or take the lead with a three. 1:25 remaining. Harvey got it to go, and we're tied. That was Kelsey Harvey. 1:10 remaining, first period. Inside, wide open. Cloninger, lay-in is good. Nice pass that time by Stormy Van Bell. And the finish by Cloninger. And Jocelyn Cook Cox with an inadvertent foul from behind, and I believe that's her second. Ebony Norman, Monica Landeck, and Macy Benedict all back in for North Idaho College. Roberts, Case, and Cook Cox get a breather. Under a minute remaining. Midgley, turnaround jump shot. No good that time by Taylor Martin. Knocked out of bounds off of Macy Benedict, and it goes to Colorado Northwestern. Fifteen-footer, too strong by Rodriguez. Ebony Norman, Cardinals with a 4-on-2. Norman goes all the way, an offensive foul. Boy, it looked like there was not a position. Second foul on Norman. It did not look like there was defensive position, but they said that Norman instigated the contact, thus the offensive foul. 33 seconds remaining. Cloninger rips it away. We'll go the other way. 22 seconds remaining. Landeck, Benedict, wide open three. Got it. Macy Benedict from beyond the arc. 7 seconds remain. Taylor Thomas, right side. Midgley doesn't go. So after one, the Cardinals up by 5, 17-12. We'll be right back after this timeout.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you. which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Welcome back to North Idaho College. First quarter shooting for the Cardinals, 53% from the field, 8 of 15, 1 of 4 from beyond the arc, 25% leading score for the Cardinals in that first period. Stormy Van Bell with 6 points on 3 of 4 shooting. Maisie Benedict, 2 of 3 from beyond the arc. She has 5 for Colorado Northwestern. They're shooting 36% from the field, 5 of 14, 1 of 3 from beyond the arc for 33%, and leading the way with 5 points is Kelsey Harvey. Just about ready to start the second period. Cardinals up by 5. Cardinals in a person defense. Inside, Martin gets it up and in. Landeck with an open three. Skips off the rim. Benedict will take it on past the three-point line, but this time it goes in. Macy Benedict with a pair of threes in the ball game. 8 points for Macy. Stolen by Norman. Benedict, open, launches a three. Doesn't go. Norman with an offensive rebound. Good hustle by Ebony Norman. Landeck lays it up and in. Monica Landeck gives the Cardinals an 8-point lead. Just underway, starting the second period. Midgley, is that a three? Yes, it is. Doesn't go. Landeck and Thomas are battling for it. Thomas knocks it out of bounds. NIC ball. Substitution for Colorado Northwestern. Rachel Prescott back in the ball game along with Kylie Tuamone. Cardinals have their starting five with the Stormy Van Bell is on the bench. Varco's in for Hurl. Norman drives the lane and puts it down with a left hand, and the Cardinals up by 10. And that'll be an over and back. Ooh. And it might have been tipped. Brian Ortmeier saying that ball was tipped, and it may have been. Back in the ballgame, Jocelyn Cook-Cox in for Ebony Norman. 8:20 remaining till the first half. Our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals, Alyssa Case. Inside, Van Bell doesn't take the shot. Barco. Landeck. Cardinals moving the ball around. Benedict with a little runner, too strong. And the rebound comes into Megan Erickson, who just checked in at the last break. Midgley tried to get it inside, knocked away by Varco. Landeck, ooh, double dribble, yep. Wanted to pass it and lost control and grabbed it and started dribbling again. Just one of those things. Stormy Van Bell out of the ball game. Shelby Cloninger back in. 7:40 remaining in the first half. Prescott launches a three, and it goes. Prescott brings the Spartans back to within 7. 7:15 remaining in the half. backdoor cut, and Benedict was looking for Cloninger to break backdoor. And Shelby went to the front door. She went to the wrong door. Dang. Cardinals back in that zone. Three ball from outside. No good for Prescott. And out of bounds to North Idaho College. As a team, the Spartans are fifth in the conference in three-point shooting at 29%. The Cardinals, well, they're not any better. They're last in the conference in shooting threes, only 28%. Landeck. Benedict from 15 on the baseline. Got it, Macy Benedict. Macy's having a nice scoring first half. 6:30 remaining. Going to drive all the way to the lane. Missed the lay-in, however, is Tuamone. And the bucket counts. I was waiting to see if it counted, and it does by Tuamone, who gets the bucket and the foul, so she'll be up there looking for the three-point play. 64% free throw shooter, averaging 7 points and five rebounds a ball game. Out of bounds to Colorado Northwestern. Long three ball, Prescott, air ball, out of bounds to North Idaho College. Benedict, Cloninger, little jump hook off the glass, doesn't go, rebound to Shelby Harvey. And here come the Spartans. Rodriguez, spin move. Rodriguez has it blocked by Cloninger. What a block by Shelby. And knocked away from Benedict, out of bounds to North Idaho College. Back in the ball game, Stormy Van Bell, Grace Varco will get a breather. Big hello to Down Under, to Grace's dad. He always has nice things to say about the broadcast. How are things down in Australia? They had fires down there, I noticed in the news. Although it's summer down there, isn't it? Yes, it is. 10 on the shot clock. Benedict. 5. They leave her alone. She shoots it and puts it down. Macy Benedict in double-digit scoring. Cardinals up by 9, just under 5 minutes. Steal by Landeck and lays it in, and it counts. Monica Landeck playing some defense. Foul is on Tyra Rodriguez, her second. And it's a media timeout. 4:54 remaining. We'll be back right after this timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm,
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica, life moves, live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
We welcome you back into our broadcast booth. The Cardinals shooting a blistering 56% from the field, 14 of 25, 2 of 6 from beyond the arc, 33%, and both of those three-pointers from Macy Benedict, 2 of 3 from beyond the arc, 5 of 8 overall. She leads the Cardinals with 12 points. Stormy Van Bell added 6 for Colorado Northwestern. They're shooting 36% from the field, 8 of 22, 2 of 6, 33% beyond the arc. And leading the way for the Spartans, the 5 points of Kelsey Harvey. The Cardinals, well, they're up by 11 with just under 5 minutes remaining here in the first half. Don't forget our halftime guest, Alyssa Case, on Meet the Cardinals. Monica Lendeck looking for the three-point play. 65% free throw shooter. Hello to everybody out in the Maple Valley. You guys get a lot of snow? You were expected to. Lendeck is out. Ebony Norman back in. Cardinals now with full court pressure. We'll set the lineup in just a second. And Gracie Roberts sticks out a knee. Roberts, Alyssa Case, Ebony Norman, Shelby Cloninger, and Stormy Van Bell in for the Cardinals. We'll get the Spartan lineup momentarily. That's Harvey, tries to get it inside to Erickson, stolen by the Cardinals. This is Roberts. Case, open three, doesn't get it. And Erickson with a rebound. Erickson to Amane, Prescott, Shelby Harvey, and who else am I missing? Riley Thompson with the basketball. Wide open, laying it up and in as Erickson. Nice pass that time, and Erickson on the finish. 4 minutes remaining in the half. Roberts cut off. Inside, Case with the left hand. Oh, she missed the lay-in. Behind the back dribble. And a travel called to Amane with the travel. Cardinal ball on the turnover. .344 remaining in the first half. Once again, Alyssa Case, our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals. Inside, Norman. Case, open three. Rolls out. Rebound to Erickson. Quickly will go the other way. To Amane. Loses it. And then fouls. So compounding the issue, turns it over, and then fouls. Boy, that'll drive a coach crazy. Grace Varco in for Shelby Cloninger. Roberts from Richmond, Nelson, New Zealand. Hi to Gracie's family. They always watch. Norman had a shot. Look at partially blocked. Cardinals get it back. Didn't hit the rim, so there's only 10 on the shot clock. Roberts, Van Bell, little run, 10-foot. Shot doesn't go. And a foul. And I think they're going to get to Amane with a push on Varco. So that's her second. Third team foul. Inside to Norman. Missed the lay-in. Tipped out of bounds by Norman. And looks like we're going to have the the Jugglers at the half coming up. But our halftime guest will be Alyssa Case on Meet the Cardinals. 2:40 remaining first half. We'll have our Meet the Cardinals, and we'll have shooting and scoring recap after our halftime interview. Stolen by the Cardinals. Ahead, Alyssa Case. Case with a lay-in. Cardinals up 12. 2 and a quarter remaining first half. Prescott. Thompson. Little 8-footer is good. Two minutes remaining till the half. Case, Colorado, playing person defense. Nice backdoor cut. Norman off the glass and in. Ebony Norman fake going to the top of the circle and cut underneath and was able to backdoor cut it and lay it in. Nice play by the Cardinals that time. Thompson, left side, nice shot by Thomas. Taylor Thomas with a 12-footer from the baseline. Cardinal lead is 10. Marco. Case on her tippy toes to get that one. Knocked out of bounds by Erickson. It'll be Cardinal ball, 17 on the shot clock. In for the first time is Clarissa Smith replacing Ebony Norman. Kelsey Harvey in for Colorado Northwestern. Roberts. 10 on the shot clock. Backdoor cut. Shot is blocked by Erickson. But the Cardinals with a steal. Varco off the glass and in. Grace Varco gets the bucket. 1 minute remaining in the first half. Cross court pass. Harvey. Left-handed shot. Doesn't go. Ball's loose. Van Bell comes out of there with it. And a foul's going to be called on Clarissa Smith on the reach-in. Cardinals had it, just lost control, and then the reach-in foul by Smith. Taylor Martin back in the ballgame for Shelby Harvey. Those changes for Brian Ortmeier. Looking for his first conference win this season. Cardinals should theoretically get the last shot. Blocked by Varco on Prescott. Out of bounds to NIC. Grace Varco just held her position. And Prescott ran into her and kind of lost her balance and then lost the ball. Good D that time by Grace. Backdoor cut. Roberts, too hard off the glass. Ball is loose. Varco ends up with it. Left-handed shot off the glass, and it counts. Grace Varco knows those angles off the backboard. When she went up to shoot that, she had no idea where the hoop was, but found it and put it off the glass. That was nice. And there it is. Halftime buzzer. The Cardinals up 39-25 at the half. Coming up next, our halftime guest, it'll be Alyssa Case on Meet the Cardinals. That's coming up right after the break.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Welcome to another edition of Meet the Cardinals, the opportunity we take to talk to some of the Cardinals stars to find out a little bit more about them both on and off the court. And from Boise, Alyssa Case, the Mountain View High School product. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing absolutely terrific. Let's talk a little bit about your season so far. Coming to North Idaho College, you had plenty of success in high school. You were state champion wrapping things up as a senior.
Yeah, we were. That was one of the best experiences I've had as a basketball player.
And you did have a chance to play here in the All-Star game in North Idaho College?
Yeah, that was fun. It was like my first chance to get on the court and see how everything worked up here.
So did you know right away after that game that you might want to come here? Or talk about how that process came down.
After the game, I talked a little bit to Chris and Carrie, and basically from that point on, I had a couple other schools I was going in between, but from there I pretty much knew that I was coming here.
You knew they were coming too. Talk a little bit about the transition going from high school to the junior college level. Did anything surprise you at all, or do you expect everything kind of fell into place?
Well, the only thing that was kind of difficult is coming from Idaho, we didn't have a shot clock, and so that transition, just learning to take care of the ball and, you know, make things happen quick but still effectively. But that was pretty much the only difference for me.
And the speed of the game, a lot of people say, well, the speed sometimes is a whole lot faster. And the competition level, too, because in high school, you could have maybe one person or two on a team, and they can dominate. Here at the college level, everybody's like that.
Yeah, exactly. We had my high school team was pretty good. We had Destiny Slocum, who is number four in the nation, and then some other good girls. But coming here, it's definitely the level of especially, like, other teams in the competition, and including our team. Everybody's just up higher in a different level, definitely.
So I guess if you've got somebody that's fourth in the country in scoring, you learn how to pass.
Yeah, most definitely. Get the ball to the player who needs it, definitely.
And see, let's get your stat line averaging right around 6 points a ball game, 2.5 rebounds, a little over 1.5 assists in the ball game. So in other words, push the ball around, bring it up, play tough defense. Is that your role as you see it, or as the coach explains it to you?
Yeah, I definitely think defense is my strongest point. But I don't know, yeah.
All right, let's talk a little bit about games like came down. We've had just two heartbreaking losses against CSI. First game of the year, you lose in double overtime, and then the loss last Saturday, half a second left, and a buzzer goes down. Being a freshman and having some experience at the high school level, how do you move on from games like that? I mean, you look at it this way, and this is the way I look at it. You took, at that point in time, the fourth best team in the country to double overtime. The second time, they beat you at a buzzer beater. So I guess to me, as I see it, tell me if I'm wrong, that means that, hey, we can play with these guys.
Yeah, I definitely agree we can play with them. I think we can beat them. We will beat them the next time we play them. I just think there's a few things that we can work on, you know, just a couple possessions of lockdown defense or starting, like, to get the team fired up on offense, just things like that, getting into flow. But, yeah, we can beat them.
All right, off the court, Alyssa Case. I asked the gals, what do I ask her about? And they something about braces and glasses? What's that?
Oh, my gosh. Okay. Yeah, I had braces and glasses going into the same year in junior high. And so they always like to give me crap about, you know.
But, you know, look at those teeth. I don't know, can we get a close come in here and look at those. Show me, look at those pearly whites. Oh, man. Mom and Dad thinking, yeah, those are thousands of dollars in that mouth. Richie's got glasses, so you're styling, you know.
Yeah, I agree.
All right. Off the court, what do you like to do, and don't say basketball?
Off the court, okay. I'm a nerd. I really actually enjoy school, like, a lot. So I study.
What class? Here's an easy one for you. What class would you like that I wouldn't?
Oh. I don't know. I like math, statistics.
Math. You know, I like numbers and statistics, and I like reading stats and that type of thing. But, you know, why do they say X is this equals Y? Who cares what Y means? You know what I mean?
There was a joke the other day, and it was like, dear algebra, sorry about your ex. Stop asking us why she left you.
I saw that on Facebook. All right, what can I tell you? Life down the road. Seemed like a smart gal. What, after your basketball career is over, what would you like to get into?
I am actually looking to be a neurosurgeon.
A what?
A neurosurgeon.
A brainiac.
Yeah.
Really? Seriously?
Yeah, I'm actually pretty interested in that. So hopefully it works out.
What's your grade point average?
Right now, I think I have a 3.94.
All right. Who gave you the 0.6? Where is that person?
Humanities.
Humanities.
Yep. Mr. Bennett.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. You've been called a neurosurgeon. Anybody that... So, in other words, you like to read medical books and that type of thing. Was there a favorite medical TV show do you like watch?
Grey's Anatomy. Grey's Anatomy.
I got to say this. Now, this isn't an interview about me, but on Netflix, last night, my wife and I watched the very first Grey's Anatomy.
Oh, did it break your heart?
Well, no. The very first one? How would the first one break my heart? It would be the last one. Yeah. So, you want to be a Dr. Shepherd?
Sure. That would be cool.
Or actually his sister.
Yeah, Amelia.
She's still alive.
She's still alive. Spoiler alert. Yeah.
All right. Favorite food on the road that you could eat if coach would let you?
Mint chocolate chip ice cream.
I think I had that last trip.
I think you showed it to me.
Yeah, I did. I'm kind of like that way. I'm just a grumpy old guy that shows the girls this is what you can eat, and I'm having seconds. So how do you like that? So you want to be a brain surgeon? Gosh, if there's somebody on the team you'd like to operate on their brain, who would it be?
Shelby. I think she's picked for everyone, right?
Yeah, I mean, I can't wait to talk to Shelby. All right, shout outs. Anybody out there, any other brainiacs you want to say hi to?
Hi, Mom and Dad and Brett. Love my family. And all my other family that's watching, thanks for your support. Yeah.
And I'm at Twitter. Are you got a Twitter account?
Yeah, at Alyssa Page Case. So follow me on Twitter and Instagram if you want.
Another edition to Beat the Cardinals. Alyssa Case, thanks for joining us.
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Anslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
There's your halftime scores. The Cardinals are leading by 14, 39-25 as we welcome you back into our broadcast area for some halftime stats. The Cardinals shooting 53% from the field in that first half, 19 of 36. 2 of 8 from beyond the arc, 25%. And Cardinals went to the free throw line only twice. They were 1 of 2. Leading the Cardinals in scoring in the first half, Macy Benedict with 12. She was 5 of 8 from the field, including 2 of 3. From beyond the arc, 8 points for Starmie Van Bell, 4 of 6 from the field, 6 points for Grace Varco, 5 for Monica Landeck, 4 points for Shelby Cloninger and Ebony Norman. So that rounds off the Cardinals scoring. For the Spartans, they shoot 39% from the field, 33% from beyond the arc, 2 of 6. They were 1 of 3 from the free throw line. No Spartan in double figures. They were led by the 6 points of Shelby Harvey. Other scores, Midgley with 3, Thompson with 2, Prescott with 3, Taylor Martin with 2, Kelsey Harvey with 5, Tuamane and Erickson each with 2 points apiece. Rebounding in that first half, Cardinals with 21, Colorado Northwest with 15. Stormy Van Bell leads the Cardinals with five rebounds in that first half. Cardinals with seven turnovers. The Spartans with 12. Largest lead in the ball game. The Cardinals with 16 points. 41 to 25. It can't be 41 to 25 because the Cardinals don't have 41 on the scoreboard. No lead changes. One tie. The Cardinals up 41 to 25. Let's listen to some of the sights and the sounds of the NIC Pep Band under the direction of Terry Jones. And we're just about ready for the second half of action. We'll be right back with the final 20 minutes as the Cardinals take on the Spartans. We'll be right back after this timeout.
Thank you for taking me out.
This place is beautiful.
It's nice to get away.
It is lovely. It's ding,
ding, ding, ding. Surprise!
Look who's here.
This place is nice.
Hey, whoa.
Hey, that's mine.
Honey, what's wrong?
We know what gets on your nerves. That's why Numerica makes it easy for members to make the most of their money with lower interest rates on loans, higher rates on deposits, and zero hidden fees. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
Hi, Jim and Sonny with the all-new Subaru Outback. The symmetrical all-wheel drive system has the capability to take you almost anywhere. There's also extensive safety features like driver eyesight assist, blind spot detection, and Subaru vehicle dynamics control. More good news, at 33 miles per gallon, it's the most fuel-efficient crossover in America. Visit Parker Subaru, just off Highway 95 in Coeur d'Alene.
Welcome back to North Idaho College. Other action tonight in the Scenic West Athletic Conference has Utah State Eastern in Twin Falls to take on CSI. Utah State Eastern 1-6, CSI at 5-1, and Snow at 5-2, taking on 6-1 Salt Lake in Salt Lake. So that's the game of the night in the Scenic West Athletic Conference. Boy, Snow could do a lot of folks a lot of help if they could knock off CSI. All right, here we go. Colorado Northwestern will start with a basketball. Prescott has it blocked by Cloninger and will go the other way. Both teams with their starting five on the field or on the court. Cloninger launches a three.
rattles off. Ben Bell, offensive board, off the glass. Norman, offensive board, and puts it in. Cardinals working hard on the glass. Just underway here in the third quarter. And a 5 second. There's no 5 second if you continue with your dribble. However, as soon as you pick up that dribble, the 5 second clock starts going. Landek has it tapped away by Erickson, gets it back. Benedict misses the three. Midgley. Three ball. Harvey, too strong. And running down, or trying to run it down, and actually running up the bleachers is Rachel Prescott. So the Cardinals will reset, and we'll see the defense employed by Brian Ortmeier's Spartans playing person defense. Van Bell, open three, short. Rebound comes down to Prescott. Prescott, one on three. Forces his shot up, and it hits the side of the backboard. She was one on three that time. Brian Ortmeier was upset, but he might be upset with the shot selection that time. Landek. Clonger thought about the shot, didn't take it. Landek. Clonger. Norman, eight on the shot clock. Norman rumbles down the lane off the glass, doesn't go. Van Bell sneaks in behind Harvey and ties her up, and it's Cardinal ball on the alternating possession. Good play by Van Bell that time. A lot of times you'll try to reach in there and grab it, and you'll draw the foul. Norman lays it up and in. Nice inbounds play that time. Benedict with the assist. Cardinals starting to open things up a little bit. 18-point lead. Bounce pass inside, short on the lay-in was Martin. Gets it back, and then they call Norman with a foul, basically just sticking out a knee. That's her third. Inside, and Shelby Cloninger ties up Taylor Martin. Held ball, and should be Colorado Northwestern. Cardinals official pointed without even looking at the official table. Cardinals just had the alternating possession, and he said to Ortmeier, yeah. Martin comes up short. Norman with a rebound. Quickly ahead, Landek. Landek lays it up in a nice play. Norman gets it going. Landek races the court. Gets the pass and lays it in. Nice play by NIC. 20-point Cardinal lead. Stolen by Landek. Tried to force it inside to Van Bell. Out of bounds to Colorado Northwestern. Midgley will go all the way. Missed the lay-in. Out of bounds to NIC. Shelby Harvey checks in the ball game for Megan Erickson. Benedict brings it in the front court. We approach 7 minutes remaining in the third. Norman throws it right to Martin. Martin gets it ahead to Harvey, and Harvey and Benedict jostling as they get into forecourt, knocked out of bounds by Benedict. It'll be the Spartans' ball. No change of possession, so 26 on the shot clock. Inside, throws it right to Cloninger. Cardinals with a 4-on-2. Landeck back to Cloninger. Off the glass and in. Nice teamwork by the Cardinals. Cardinals playing on the hedge. Knocked away by Van Bell. Benedict ahead to Cloninger. Off the glass, comes up too short. And Norman with the offensive board and throws it away. Jocelyn Cook-Cox into the ball game. And a timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. We'll be right back after the break.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you. Which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
6:08 remaining in the third period. Cardinals in this second half shooting 33% from the field, 3 of 9. 0 from 3 from beyond the arc. Macy Benedict leads the Cardinals with 12 points. Colorado Northwestern, well, they're still 0 for in this second half. They're 0 for 6 from the field, 0 of 1 from beyond the arc. Nobody for the Spartans in double figures. Shelby Harvey remains the leading scorer with 6 in the ballgame. Don't forget, coming up, we'll have men's action 20 minutes after the conclusion of this one. We'll start it off with the pregame show with head coach Corey Simmons. Cardinals in the latest NJCAA poll are ranked 4th in the country. Midgley from 10, short. Landeck with a rebound. Marco. Benedict into Van Bell in the lane. And thought she was pushed. Ball came out of her hand. She was shooting it left-handed, and it went behind the backboard. .546 remaining, third quarter. And pretty much all Cardinals. Midgley. Too strong on the lay-in. And Midgley with a foul. It'll be Cardinal ball. And that's Midgley's first foul. It'll be Cardinal ball right underneath us here. Our vantage point at Rolly Williams Court. Jocelyn Cook-Cox in the lane. Little left-handed shot from 8, and it rolls in. Nice shot by Jocelyn. Cardinals up a bunch. And a steal. Benedict sets, launches a three. Doesn't go. Rebound inside by Harvey. And she hangs on for dear life as she's swarmed after grabbing that defensive rebound. 4:26 remaining. Trying to lob it inside for Harvey. Too strong on the pass. And the Cardinals come away with the errant pass by Midgley. We'll go the other way. Benedict goes baseline. Skip pass. Jocelyn Cook Cox for three. Offensive board. Van Bell. Counting down to 4 minutes remaining, third quarter. Inside, Cook Cox. Little six-footer with a right hand is good. Jocelyn Cook Cox, a lefty, shot it right-handed the time and put it down. I couldn't do anything with my left hand. Shot that time by Harvey. I couldn't shoot left-handed if I had to. I could barely shoot right-handed. I'm a double threat. I can't shoot from each side. Blocking foul on Midgley as Benedict goes to the baseline. And we've got a media timeout. We'll take one as well. 3:29 remaining in the third quarter. Cardinals up big when we come back.
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Anslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Welcome back to North Idaho College. This is Dick Haugen. Nice to have you with us. Scenic West Athletic Conference action as the 3-3 NIC Cardinals hosting the 0-7 Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. Utah State Eastern comes to town on Saturday. Lady Cardinals at 3. The men at 5. We'll have both games on the webcast with the pregame show 10 minutes prior to tip-off. So substitutions for the Cardinals. Alyssa Case back in for NIC along with Gracie Roberts and Grace Varco. Case with a little 10-footer from the right side is good. Case comes off the bench firing. Reynolds. This is Harvey. Try to backdoor cut it is to Amane, and Cardinals come up with a steal. Quickly ahead, Jocelyn Cook-Cox. Reverse lay and overshoots the backboard, or the basket, actually. And Taylor Thomas with a rebound. 2:50 remaining in the third. And a block, no foul called. Shot up by Erickson, no good. And Colorado Northwestern still without a bucket in this third quarter. Case shot too strong. Ball is batted around. And the Spartans come out of there with it. Colorado Northwestern have gone 7.5 minutes without a bucket. Short the three ball by Tulamane. Gets the ball back and a foul going to be called on Gracie Roberts. Carissa Smith, Stormy Van Bell, and Charity Marlatt in for the Cardinals. Cloninger, Varco, and Cook Cox get a little bit of a breather. In the lane, still doesn't go. Cardinals pitching a shutout here in the third quarter. inside Marlatt. Smith had the shot, didn't take it, drops in. Says, I'll get a couple feet short or closer, and she puts it down. Cardinals up by 30. A 26-0 run start the third quarter. Inside, doesn't go for Erickson, but she'll go to the free throw line. Marlatt with a personal foul. It was 39-25 at the end of the half. Third team foul on the Cardinals. Megan Erickson, 58% free throw shooter.
At the line for the Spartans, number 44, Megan Erickson.
And Sydney Davis getting a chance for some first half action for the Cardinals. Just recently academically eligible. The 5'9 freshman out of Missoula, Montana. Still no points for the Spartans in the third. I don't think I've ever seen a... And a foul inside. I think they got Erickson knocking down Marlatt. Riley Thompson back in the ball game for the Spartans, replacing Sierra Reynolds. Gracie Roberts will inbound it. Knocked out of bounds by Taylor Thomas on the overplay. 1:19 remaining in the third period. Smith. Case, open three. Got it. Alyssa Case. Inside, off the glass, doesn't go by Erickson, and the Cardinals get the rebound, under a minute remaining. Smith with a three, and she's got it. 40 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Cardinals have not given up a point. Thomas missed the lay-in. But fouled by Gracie Roberts. It was 39-25 at the half. Thomas, 64% free throw shooter. Oh. This is like a foot sliver that you can't find and you keep walking on it, you know, painful. And missed it. And Case ends up with it. Smith, Roberts, 13 on the game clock. Smith launches a three. That was way off, you could see at the angle. We'll go the other way. Tolomane has it. Saves it to Thomas, and Thomas gets a bucket with 0.1 seconds remaining to avoid being shut out in the period. Unbelievable. 61-27 will go to the final 10 minutes right after the break.
Thank you for taking me out.
This place is beautiful.
It's nice to get away.
It is lovely. It's ding,
ding, ding, ding. Surprise!
Look who's here.
This place is nice.
Hey, whoa.
Hey, that's mine.
Honey, what's wrong? We know what gets on your nerves. That's why Numerica makes it easy for members to make the most of their money with lower interest rates on loans, higher rates on deposits, and zero hidden fees. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
Hi, Jim and Sunny with the all-new Subaru Outback. The symmetrical all-wheel drive system has the capability to take you almost anywhere. There's also extensive safety features like driver eyesight assist, blind spot detection, and Subaru vehicle dynamics control. More good news, at 33 miles per gallon, it's the most fuel-efficient crossover in America. Visit Parker Subaru, just off Highway 95 in Coeur d'Alene.
The Cardinals outscoring the Spartans 20-2 in that third period. Cardinals in the second half shooting 47%, 9 of 19, 25% from beyond the arc, 2 of 8. Macy Benedict leads the Cardinals with 12. For Colorado Northwestern, they were 1 of 14 in that third period, 7% in the ball game. Cardinals said they wanted to concentrate on defense. I would imagine that Chris Carlson has to be rather pleased with that third period. Backdoor cut. Smith lays it up and in. Nice pass from the top. Cardinals with no starters on the floor. Reverse lay-in is good by Riley Thompson. I take that back. Macy Benedict is on the floor. And a foul inside. Kylie Olson, the Chalice, Idaho product, getting set to come in for the Cardinals. So Chris Carlson will be able to clear his bench. Fouls on Erickson. Sid Davis at the free throw line. Her first free throw of the year. And a foul inside. They're going to get Sid Davis. They do. Just underway here in the fourth. Cardinals looking to get above 500 in conference. And you would think with a 33-point lead, it would be safe. Out of bounds to the Spartans. Thomas in the lane, partially blocked by Marlatt, gets it back. Out on top, Thompson gets the shot. That was a two. Smith. Shot is too strong. Rebound to Amane. We'll go the other way. On the dribble drive. Bounces off to Thompson, who lays it in. And the Spartans run a nice break that time and get the finish. 8:38 remaining. Three ball. Nothing but net. Kaylee Olson puts it down for the Cardinals. And a steal. Benedict. And a pushing called to Lamane. That's her third in the ball game is Tyra Rodriguez and Sarah Midgley for head coach Brian Ortmeier. Benedict. Tried to get the pass to Smith, stolen. Rodriguez. Midgley going to drive the lane. Off the glass and in, and it counts. Foul on Sydney Davis. And the second foul on Davis. Midgley, 74%. And I'm not sure what was going on there, but Megan Erickson, you saw on your screen, ran into the lane for reasons unknown. Boy, when it rains, it pours, and that's in buckets. Ebony Norman back in for NIC. Marlatt. Benedict for a long three, and it got it, Macy Benedict. Cardo's up 33. Ball is loose. Ebony Norman. Benedict hands it off. Laying is good by Sid Davis. Kelsey Harvey. Inside, too strong in the shot by Erickson. And Sidney Davis gets the rebound, and then a foul in backcourt by Megan Erickson. So Sidney Davis, the 5'9 freshman, getting some valuable playing time. Shelby Harvey back in the ball game, along with Rachel Prescott for Colorado Northwestern. Been a nice shooting game for Macy Benedict tonight beyond the arc. She's got three threes in the lane. Shot is no good that time by Davis, but she'll go to the free throw line. Kelsey Harvey, the foul, her first, fourth team foul. Teammates give her a holler. Well liked on the team. Sydney Davis, recently eligible at the semester, and she's out there. Cardinal bench having a good time. When you're up by 30, everything's a hoot and a holler. On the baseline, Midgley. Rattles out, doesn't go. Offensive rebound doesn't go by Prescott. Gets another shot at it, and it finally drops. 6:25 remaining in the ball game. Colorado Northwestern with only 13 points in the entire second half. Backdoor cut, Norman. Left elbow shot bounces, doesn't go by Davis. And the Spartans bring it in the front court. Harvey, nice shot. That's a two. Was on the line. Kelsey Harvey with the deuce. 5:50 remaining. Benedict. Step around move. Left hand shot off the glass. Doesn't go. Rebound to the Spartans. Kelsey Harvey with the carom. Spartans with a three on two. Three ball, Kelsey Harvey, got it. .520 remaining. We'll have a scoring recap and shooting percentages after the ball game. There's a long three that time by Olsen, doesn't go, and a rebound to Tyra Rodriguez. Here come the Spartans. Rodriguez going to go coast-to-coast, blocked by Norman. And a technical foul on Colorado Northwestern. And Brian Ortmeier, a microcosm of his season. And we'll take a media timeout, let everybody cool off a little bit. 5 minutes remaining. Cardinals up big, shooting tees when we come back.
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Welcome back inside our broadcast location. The Cardinals shooting 48% in the second half, 13 of 27, 36% from beyond the arc, 4 of 11. Leading scorer for the Cardinals, Macy Benedict, 15 points, including 3 of 6 from beyond the arc. In the second half, Colorado Northwestern shooting 31%, 8 of 26, 1 of 3 from beyond the arc. One player in double figures, Kelsey Harvey, she has 10. Macy Benedict shooting the technical. Macy now with 16 in the ball game. And she'll come out replaced by Gracie Roberts. So the Cardinals will improve the 16-4 overall, 4-3 in the Scenic West Athletic Conference, and that is looking right down on the floor as we are obviously on top of things here at Roley Williams Court. Well done on the cameraman there, young man. It's hard because you're looking right down at him. Driving the baseline, doesn't go, and a moving screen, I think they catch Grace Varco. .443 remaining. And I didn't add the point on the Macy Benedict technical, so I will do that right now. Just inside the free throw line, Kelsey Harvey with the bucket. Olson inside Varco. Doesn't get it. Offensive board. Varco gets it. Gets another offensive board and then gets it outside. Good hustle by Grace inside. Norman off the glass and in. Ebony Norman with the left hand. .31 NIC lead. .348 remaining. Harvey from the baseline is good. Cardinals defensively are fourth in the conference in defense at 61-4 per ball game, and they're going to match that tonight. Cloninger from 8 feet is good. Three ball, Midgley, too strong. Ball is batted around. And Prescott comes out of the pack. Cross court, Rodriguez for three. Got it, nice shot. Approaching 3 minutes remaining in the ball game. Inside Cloninger. Shelby, a little turnaround shot, too strong. Rebound to Harvey. And nice hustle that time and putting it in is Prescott. One thing, Brian Ortmeier's players are still playing hard. They may be outgunned, but they're certainly not giving up as Midgley commits the foul. Roberts goes to the free throw line to shoot a pair. 36% free throw shooter. Come on, Gracie. You're a better shot than that. Come on, put him in. That'll teach me. Gracie, one of the fun gals on this team. The class clown, if there is such a thing, is definitely Shelby Cloninger. She'll be our guest in the Salt Lake game next Thursday.
If you missed our halftime guest with Alyssa Case, we'll have it for you again up on our YouTube site at nicathletics.com. You go to our webpage and then scroll down and look for the YouTube banner, and we'll have it for you. Same thing with the men's. Meet the Cardinals guest, and that would be Dylan Okoro. Three ball, Midgley rolls out, rebound. Jocelyn Cook-Cox, who's back in the ball game. Gracie from three, nothing but net, Gracie Roberts. Cardinals back up by 30 with 2 minutes remaining in the ball game. Three ball, Prescott, and it rolls in. They call it a two. The foot was on the line. Case. Sid Davis. Inside to Marlatt. Backdoor cut. Case missed the lay-in, oh boy. Prescott. .120 remaining. Runner in the lane doesn't go that time for Kanani Naipo. And she'll go to the free throw line to shoot two. One more. .117 remaining in the ball game. Roberts from the baseline doesn't go. Ball is loose. Jocelyn Cook-Cox gets it. Cardinals get a new shot clock as we approach 1 minute remaining. Case. Marlatt. Roberts. A scoop shot doesn't go, but she's fouled. And Gracie will shoot two. Fourth foul on Midgley. Gracie, 36% free throw shooter. And she gets them both. 48 seconds remaining. Little runner in the lane doesn't go that time for Naipo, and the Cardinals get it. 34 seconds remaining in the ball game. Jocelyn Cook-Cox, 13 on the shot clock, 20 on the game clock. Roberts tried to get it inside to Marlatt, knocked out of bounds. It'll be Cardinal ball. 16-5 on the game clock, 9 seconds on the shot clock. Marlatt inside. Basket is good. Davis gets the bucket. 11 seconds remaining. Martin doesn't go, out of bounds with 9/10 of a second remaining. And not a whole lot that Colorado Northwestern can do. They get it in. Shot is blocked by Jocelyn Cook-Cox. And there's your final score. NIC Cardinals win big, 86-56. We'll be back with final shooting stats and a scoring recap right after this timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm, you know, from...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica, life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
When looking for a vehicle, what do you want? A big selection? The lowest price? More for your trade? Great customer service? Or do you want it all? Tom has it all at Lake City Ford. Come see our showroom with the easiest and friendliest sales staff you'll find anywhere. Giant factory rebates on America's best-selling truck, Ford F-Series. And at Lake City Ford, you can always buy new Fords at bargain prices every day of the week. Nobody sells, services, and discounts Fords like Coeur d'Alene's Ford Giant. Tom Addis, Lake City Ford, 315 Clayton Avenue in Coeur d'Alene, or visit us at lakecityford.com.
Welcome inside our broadcast area. There's your final scores. The Lady Cardinals prevail by 30, 86-56 over Colorado Northwestern. Here's your final shooting and recap. Cardinals shoot 50% from the field, 36 of 72, 35% from beyond the arc, 7 of 20, 7 of 12 from the free throw line. Macy Benedict led all scores with 16 points in the ball game. She was 6 of 12 from the field, including 3 of 6 from beyond the arc. Other scores in the ballgame, 8 for Shelby Cloninger, 8 for Ebony Norman, and 8 for Stormy Van Bell, with a very balanced scoring for the Cardinals. 6 points for Sid Davis, Gracie Roberts with 6, 7 for Alyssa Case, 3 for Kaylee Olson, Monica Landeck had 7, Jocelyn Cook was with 4, and Clarissa Smith with 7, Grace Barco with 6. Cardinals out rebound Colorado Northwestern 45-22. Stormy Van Bell had 10 rebounds for NIC. For Colorado Northwestern, they shoot 38% from the field, 24 of 62, 4 of 11 from beyond the arc, 36%, 4 of 12 from the free throw line, 33%. One player in double figures for Colorado Northwestern, Kelsey Harvey, with 12 points in the ball game, a fine shooting effort tonight. She was 5 of 6 from the field, including 2 of 3 from beyond the arc. Other scores, Taylor Thomas with 2, Sarah Midgley with 5, 9 for Riley Thompson, and Rachel Prescott, 3 for Tyra Rodriguez. Shelby Harvey with 8, 2 for Taylor Martin, 2 for Napio, and 2 for Tayamanu and Erickson. So the Cardinals win it big, 86-56 with a victory. NIC now 4-3 in conference play. Colorado falls to 0-8. Coming up next in just about 8 minutes or so, we'll have the men's game as the Cardinals fourth in the country, 21-0, take on Colorado Northwestern, who's having a rough season indeed. The Spartans are 0-7 in conference, 2-19 overall. So the Lady Cardinals, they win big. There's your final score. We'll be back with the men's game in just about 8 minutes.